What's going on, everybody? Jason here, and today we're gonna talk about this 2021 Jeep Wrangler Unlimited Rubicon 4xe. Starting things off in the front, this 4xe is standard with the LED lighting, along with the lighting integrated into the front fender flares. Also, you've got in the steel bumper group your fog lights on both sides. Also, you'll notice from the factory you get the Mopar satin black grille, which is an option that you can get, or you can keep it body colored as with the Stingray of this vehicle. Also, with this 4xe, you get the upgraded steel bumper, which is not standard on this. It's an upgraded feature, and I think this looks way better and it just feels very, very sturdy. Another feature that this 4xe has is a front-facing camera. This is a front-facing off-road camera actually, and it's also got this little cleaner if you get dirt or anything on there. One press of a button and it'll just clean your lens in the front. And my absolute favorite feature on the 4xes is that you get these blue tow hooks in the front and in the rear, but you only get this on the Rubicon. On the Sahara, they are blacked out, and I wish that they made it blue as well like the Rubicons, because it just looks very, very nice. Also on the Rubicons, you get the 4xe badging up top with the blue little design here. And then on the side here, Rubicon, typically on a normal one, it's outlined in red, but this one, because it's a 4xe, it's outlined in blue. Also, along with your trail rated badging, and then the Jeep Wrangler Unlimited badging here is also outlined in blue, which looks absolutely beautiful. And on all of the Rubicons, you get these kind of vented feeling. This is not functional, it just looks really, really nice. Taking a look at the 4xe from the side view, you can see the beautiful color, which is the Stingray color that this is painted in. And with the blue contrast, I think it looks way better. My favorite is the white on blue, but this also looks very, very unique. And of course, a 4xe won't be a 4xe without your plug right here, which is your charging ports, which I'll go over in a little bit here. And taking a look at the wheels, you get these nice looking 17 inch off-road wheels with the white lettering around on all of the wheels, and it just looks really, really cool, especially the design with the black insert and like the kind of like the silver machine finish around the edges, and it ties into the Jeep very, very nicely. And on the side here at the bottom, you get this very sturdy rock slider, so if you do need to take it off-roading, I'm sure you're gonna take it off-roading, it'll protect you and it'll actually protect the vehicle as well, which is really, really good to have, especially if you're taking this off-roading. And speaking of off-roading, you can still enjoy off-roading in the 4xe, and this thing can actually handle fording streams up to 75 centimeters in depth. So even though it's a 4xe, you can still enjoy it. And also on this particular Rubicon 4xe, it has the body color hardtop, which looks nice. I personally prefer this as from the black top. A small little unique feature for the 4xes only, this you cannot open anymore. There's a button inside which you can press. Again, that has to do with the whole 4xe system and the gas pressure, you know, all of that stuff to release it. Coming to the rear of the 4xe, looks traditional like any other Rubicon. You've got your LED lighting in the back, you got your spare tire in the back, along with your backup camera right over here. This one's also got the hitch at the back, and also at the bottom, because you have a hitch, you've got your plugs here for your trailer or anything that you need to tow. And like I mentioned, you've got the blue tow hook in the rear, along with the 4xe badging in the back. If we open up the rear in the back, you've got a massive, massive box. This is because this vehicle has the dual top group. In here is your soft top, and again, it takes up a lot of space, so you might want to have two people take it out when you do purchase a dual top. And everything else is pretty much the same as compared to a normal Rubicon. You've got your plaque over here. Everything else underneath this is exactly the same how it would be. This is just the 4xe. This Rubicon also has all the safety features, so you can notice here in the rear bumper, you've got your rear parking sensors and all of that good stuff. If you open up the back here, again, you're greeted with your dual top box back here. But if you take a look at the material that they're using, it's, you know, the same as any other Rubicon, but something cool on the 4xes is that you'll see blue stitching along with the blue tow hooks all around the vehicle, which I think makes it look very unique being it a 4xe. Also at the bottom here within the seats, you've got 4xe badging kind of right over here on both sides. And obviously the seats fold down in like any other vehicle, but because this is a 4xe, if you fold these seats over and you kind of pull this cushion, this is the part where you would sit. If you fold it over, you're greeted by your batteries underneath on both sides. And in the middle up here, you've got your speakers on both sides, which is obviously, again, traditional on every Jeep that you can get. Moving on to the front, again, you've got that same quality material from the back in the front as well, along with the blue stitching, which looks absolutely nice. You've got your lock buttons and then your mirror controls, and then a little bit of cargo space to put anything that you need. And on the inside, on the seats, the front passenger and driver seats, you can see Rubicon is in blue now. And also that blue stitching goes around everywhere, which looks beautiful. These seats are leather seats and they feel absolutely beautiful. And they're very, very nice and plush. And you know, they're very comfortable, especially if you want to go off-roading for a while. You'll have no problem, as you guys are aware, or if you've driven a Jeep Rubicon before, you know how it is. And all of your seats are manual adjustable. This is to raise the seat, your lumbar, and this is to move this part front and back. At the bottom, you've got your traditional pedal layout, nothing really special going on there. And if you move up, here is the button that I was talking about for the gas cap release, which I'll show you in a second. These are the new buttons here. Obviously it's a 4xe, so you can put in hybrid, electric, and e-save mode, which I'll cover these, exactly what each of these mean and what they do. Up top, you've got your lighting controls. In the center here, you've got for your fog lights. You've got your dimmers over here, and the steering wheel is manual adjustable. Now, if I press this, you can't hear it, but there is a sound being made right now. It takes a couple of seconds. Wait for it. There you are. And you are good to go. And you just lock it back in place. And again, the whole stitching is all around the vehicle, even on the dashboard. This right here is your charging bar. It tells you how much charge you have left. This lights up once you plug in the vehicle. On the steering wheel, I'm not sure if you can see, but you've got, again, your blue stitching all around, which looks really, really nice. You've got your center gauge controls over here, your Bluetooth, along with your adaptive cruise control, because this does have forward collision warning and all of that. And then your cruise control settings, along with that beautiful Jeep logo in the middle. And right over here, you've got your controls for the rear windshield wiper and the front. And over here, your turn signals and high beams. Taking a look at the center gauge cluster, you've got your RPMs over here, along with your speed in the center. And then also, because 4xe, you've got how much power you're using, and then the charge over here. Also, you'll notice the battery percentage is up there. Right now, this is not fully charged, so once you charge it, obviously that will go up. And then you've got how many miles or kilometers, if you're Canadian, you've got while you are on electric mode, or how much you have while you've charged the vehicle. At the bottom there, it'll show how much gas mileage you have, and then this will be your total combined mileage. And when you turn on the 4xe, you're greeted with this nice little 4xe logo, which looks really, really cool. Now, in terms of the center gauge cluster, you've got a bunch of options that you can flick through. For example, again, you can see your speed right there. You've got your vehicle information. You've got your off-roading information here. It'll tell you if your sway bars are connected, disconnected. You've got your driver assist setting there. You've got your fuel economy setting here. Hybrid information. This will actually tell you how much you've driven solely electric and how much you've used the gas engine, which is really cool. You've got your trip info right here. You've got your audio settings here. Messages, screen setup, and then you're back to your speed over here. In the center handrest, again, very nice feeling, along with that blue stitching all around. If you open up the first section here, you've got a little bit of room, put something. And if you open up the second section here, you've got more room and a bunch of stuff, which I'll go over in a second. Let me just remove all of that out. You've got a ton of room in here to put whatever you need to. You've also got a USB charger in there as well. So in this box, you've got your windshield tie down straps, which does come with the vehicle if you get the option. Otherwise, it will not come with it. And over here, you've got your hitch cover at the back. If you're not using it, you can put this beautiful Jeep cover on top of it. And in this here, you've got your tools to take off the doors or your back panel at the rear. And everything is in there, as you can see. This is what you need to take off everything. Just make sure you don't lose it. And again, you've got your traditional push to start button right over there. In the center here, you've got your cup holders, your parking brake, your off-roading gears, and then your main gear selector here. Again, everything has that blue stitching all around, which looks mint. And if we take a look above, you've got four auxiliary ports here. If you ever need to put accessories on the vehicle, you can do that for sure. And just have it plugged into one of these and you can choose whatever you want it. You've got your sway bar here, and you've got your front and rear lockers right here, which you can kind of do however you need to do it if you're going off-roading. Right above that, you've got your 12-volt little adapter here if you need to put a charger in there or whatever. You've got your window controls here. You've got your media ports here, USB, Type-C, and then your auxiliary port right there. And moving up right above that, you've got your traditional heating and cooling system and your buttons here. You've got your parking sensors, screen off option, heated steering wheel, heated seats, all of that good stuff. And because it's a 4xe, you've got your max regen button here. And on the display, it'll show max regen is on. So what does this button do? Now, you can drive without turning this on. So pretty much what regeneration is when you're slowing down or stopping the vehicle, it will recharge your battery and actually give you more range. But if you want to take it a step further, you press this, leave it on, and you will actually feel the vehicle slowing down once you let off the accelerator. And this will actually help recharge your battery faster, you know, when you're slowing down or stopping. Up top, you've got your touchscreen, which is the same in all of the Jeeps here. And again, you can choose from media, climate. If you click that, again, you can move things around. If you don't want to use these buttons down here, you can just use the touchscreen up there. You've got your controls. This is for your heated seats, heated steering wheel, driver side, and then you've got your passenger side as well. You've got your mirror dimmer, backup camera, and then your forward camera as well right there. If you click backup camera, again, you can see it there. You can also click through here to see your forward camera as well. If you want to clean it, you just press this, and that little thing that I showed you right under the camera squirts some water and it cleans it. You've also got your navigation built right in, which is super easy. You've got your phone for Bluetooth and then your settings over here. And because this is the 4xe, you've got your own page here. So if you go into apps and then you're going to scroll over, you're going to select hybrid electric pages. Here you can see everything that the vehicle is doing, how much power the engine's using, how much is coming from the battery, and then how much of the climate you're using in power. And right here you can see the power flow, you can see your driving history, how you've driven on gas and battery, your charging schedule you can set up, especially if you're charging at home. You can tell the vehicle when to start charging and when to stop charging. Also, you've got your e-save mode here as well. You can do if you want to save the battery or if you want to save the charge after. Up top, you've got your rear view mirror, and right above it, you've got your airbag light, assist, and SOS. And of course, you've got your hard top at the top here. And now, this vehicle in particular has these black inserts in here. This is just to dampen the noise. Normally on a Jeep Rubicon or a Sahara or whatever, this will just all be white and this piece will not be there. This is in both the front, and I'm not sure if you can see it, but in the back as well. And before I get into all of these modes here, let me show you something really, really cool. Normally when the Jeep is on, you'll hear it, but it's a 4xe. There's no sound coming out. Obviously, unless you use a lot of, you know, your climate or you need more power, then the engine will kick in. But look at this. Imagine going off-roading silently. Okay, so now let's talk about these three modes right here and what they do. If you put the vehicle into hybrid mode, it is gonna turn on. I'm pretty sure you just heard that. And hybrid is set by default. So when you start the vehicle, it's gonna set that by default. And this obviously combines both the torque from the 2-liter turbo engine that this has and the electric motors, which in return, this gives you maximum horsepower and instant torque for the best acceleration. And in hybrid mode, the electric power is consumed first for maximum savings for you. Now, if you switch it into electric mode, the vehicle is gonna go silent, which is pretty weird at first, but you get used to it. So in electric mode, obviously the vehicle only runs in, you know, electric mode on the batteries that it has until the battery reaches minimum charge, or when you need that torque to kick in, then your gas engine will kick in as well. And the last option, which is e-save over here, again, you'll hear that engine kick in, and pretty much the e-save mode saves the battery charge for later use. Now, speaking of the battery and charging, if you open this up, again, when you plug the vehicle in, it'll give you indication if the vehicle's charging or if it's an error. It'll let you know, and that way you know exactly what's going on with the vehicle. Plus, when you plug this in, your light bar that I showed you over there will turn on and start blinking. So when it comes to charging your 4xe, if you want to charge quicker, you can charge in 2 hours on a level 2, which will fully charge the vehicle. And if you want to charge at home and you don't have a level 2 charger, it'll charge in about 12 hours on a level 1 charger. And that's because you're using your traditional plugs at home, which any outlet you can use on. And that typically takes a little bit longer because the voltage is lower. And if you put the Jeep in electric mode, it's obviously going to go silent, being it a 4xe. But here's the cool thing. If you go ahead and try and open your hood latch here, so you open this side, and then as soon as you come to this side, it will turn on. Now, moving on to what powers this 4xe. It's the Jeep's 2-liter turbo engine, and it's the plug-in hybrid electric vehicle engine. And it has the 17 kilowatt lithium ion battery. And in terms of power, this produces 375 horsepower, with 470 foot-pound of torque. So this thing can get up and go. And if you plan on driving this in full electric, you'll get about 34 kilometers out of this, which obviously if you commute close and you have work close by, you're not gonna be using any gas. And on top of that, everywhere you go, you're gonna be constantly plugging it in, whether it be at home, at work, or wherever you're going, because every shopping center nowadays has a charging section. And over on the passenger side, again, right here, you traditionally will have on a Rubicon is the red little panel here, but it's black with the blue stitching, obviously because of a 4xe. And obviously you've got your grab handle here for the Wrangler. It says right on there. If you open this up, you've got a little bit of storage in here to put whatever you need to. As for the exact options on this 2021 Wrangler Unlimited Rubicon 4xe, here's the exact window sticker with the base price without any options. And you can see here the standard options that it's got, and then your upgraded options that this vehicle has right there, along with your total price with the options. And that's it for this beautiful 2021 Jeep Wrangler Unlimited Rubicon 4xe. Let me know in the comments down below if you love this or if you hate it.